Hello guys, today I'm going to show you how I change the front brake disc and pads on a Mark III Ford Focus, or if you're in the States, I believe you call it rotors and pads. Okay, I'm going to start by popping the bonnet open so I can access the brake reservoir. This is the brake fluid reservoir. I'm going to take the cap off and leave it to a side. Here you can see I've already jacked up the vehicle and taken the wheel off. Now I'm going to turn the steering outwards so the caliper is more accessible. So first, what I like to do is take the dust caps off. I'm using a mini pry bar for this, but you could use a flat head or you could just use your fingernails. Now for the spring. To help it loosen, I'm spraying some WD-40 on it. I'm gonna pry the spring off, but do be careful as they will fly off. Now to push the piston back. The piston needs to be pushed back evenly as shown here by my inaccurate drawing. An uneven push to one side of the piston can damage the caliper, and if that happens, you'll need to replace the caliper too. So to avoid unnecessary setback, I recommend using a caliper rewind tool. There are many different types to choose from, all do the job just fine. I, on the other hand, will be using my pry bar to perform this task. Copy at your own risk. Place the pry bar between the gaps here, here, or here, all of which will be aligned with the center of the piston. Although I'm placing an uneven pressure with the pry bar, the brake pads will spread the pressure and pass on even force onto the piston. Do not place the pry bar directly onto the piston. As you can see, the piston has been pushed back completely. Now I'm spraying WD-40 on the guide pins so later they can come out of the rubber sleeves easily. To loosen the guide pins, I'm using a 7mm Allen key socket, small extension and a ratchet. Now that it's loose, I remove the ratchet and turn with my fingers until the pins come off. Carefully remove the caliper. Don't let the brake caliper hang by the brake line as it will damage it. Best way to secure the caliper will be to hang it on the springs with a bungee cord. As I misplaced my bungee cord, I'm going to use a cable tie to secure it. Use a 18mm impact socket to remove brake carrier bolts. If your brake pad hasn't fallen off already, remove them. I'm using an impact wrench over here, but you can use a manual wrench instead. Remove brake carrier. Remove brake disc. This one is loose, but sometimes they get stuck and you need to whack it with a hammer. Using a wire brush, remove brake residue and rust from the hub and the brake carrier. The brake disc I'm using has an oil coating that needs to be removed before installation. I am using brake cleaner and a clean rag to wipe off the coating. Fit new brake disc onto the hub. Replace brake carrier.
Yeah, the rust.
No, not the rust, the mount.
Oh, the thickness.
Yeah.
So that's what happens, they end up thinning out.
Yeah.
So wait, what's the whole purpose of the pads there? Now I'll be honest, like car wise, but stuff like that, I have no idea.
Oh, so what happens is when you press the brakes, this pad rubs against the disc, basically it grabs it, and that's what slows the wheels down. Okay. And in the process, this gets worn out. Apply a thin layer of brake grease to the pads as indicated by the red arrows. Unfortunately, I forgot to record this part, hence the picture. Place the outer pad on the brake holder. Push the inner pad into the caliper piston. In In the process, I have touched and contaminated the pad. Not to worry, a few spray of brake cleaner will remove the dirt. Fit on brake caliper. These guide pin looks okay, so I'm gonna put them back in. If you had rust or uneven surface, I would have sanded them down and greased them. Replace dust cover. Replace caliper spring. I'm using a pair of pliers to assist me. Replace wheel. Once this side is complete, move on to the other side. The procedure is the same. Pump the brake pedal about 10 times or until it gets hard. Check that the brake fluid is at its maximum level. Then just screw the cap back on. Job done! Just be careful though. The new pads have to bed in first, so leave a longer braking distance when you drive. Hey, if you found this video helpful, why don't you subscribe to my channel? Yeah.